next presentation will be by Charles Bridwell.
I'd like to tell what you'll be presenting in the quarter or the year coming next.
What's that?
And like, whenever you announce this, could you tell what we will give you? Like a year quarter?
Charles would be the lead for experiment 3.
My name is Charles Bougeau, and I'll be the lead for next week's experiment 4, group 1. And I want to say that it's about air conditioning. This is what we think of as air conditioning today, and this is what people thought of air conditioning in the past. When you cut block device, a little bit of history. The background. The first attempt at human-made air conditioning or cooling, one of the first, was Benjamin Franklin. He took alcohol, very quickly evaporating alcohol, and sprayed it onto a thermometer. And over time, as it evaporated, he noticed a sheet of ice formed, and then it got to about 7 degrees Celsius. And he was quoted as saying that you could freeze a man on a warm summer day. That was in about 1760 something. In the early 1800s, it became the first refrigeration cycle of compression and decompression of a liquid and the cooling. And then today we have it on a much larger scale using compression and decompression of a liquid. The theory behind air conditioning and cooling is first the coefficient of performance, the COP, the quantity of the desired commodity over the expenditure to make that commodity. And then we have the cooling and heating take place when special fluids are compressed and then expanded in an environment. We'll get to them a little bit. In modern applications, they're infinite. You can think of them in any little thing. For us, we mostly think of heating in winter and cooling in the summer. In your refrigerator, some manufacturers call for the heating of one piece and the cooling of another piece, and then they're put together, and when they both reach room temperature, the heated one is contracted and the cooled one is expanded, and they have a press fit together. And then also some research uses air conditioning. I'm sure you can think of many other different applications. In particular, this experiment, the objective is to be able to perform the thermodynamic analysis of the air conditioner system, to understand the charge level of the unit and how that affects performance, the level of, or the amount of freon in the system. And we also need to understand and be able to calculate the coefficient of performance, as I said earlier, the COP. For this experiment, here's what we're gonna be doing. We have, we start off with the compressor up at the top. It leaves the compressor with a vapor, and it travels to the condenser, where in the condenser is transformed from a liquid or from a vapor to a liquid. It then travels from the condenser to the expansion valve, where it expands slightly and becomes a liquid and a vapor combined. It then leaves the expansion valve on its way to the evaporator, where in the evaporator it becomes it chills and becomes a vapor, absorbing heat. And then it returns back around to the compressor to start the cycle all over again. In our particular one, we're going to have a reservoir in there and a couple of other parts. The 1, 2, 3, and 4 all mark where our thermocouples and our pressure valves, our pressure transducers will be in the system. We'll be taking 4 pressure readings and 4 temperature readings during this experiment. The procedure of our predicted experiment is first to turn it on at the breaker box. We'll then check to make sure all 4 temperatures and pressures are equal, hopefully room temperature. If they're not equal, we'll need to go through and calibrate, which is in the lab manual. We turn on the heat pump and set it up with the correct amount of freon, which I was talking about the charge level, and allow it to reach a steady state. Make sure it releases a steady state is important. Then we thermodynamic analysis of the evaporator. Temperature pressure readings from the freon and the freon charges, and then we need to make sure we shut down the system safely. The equations, both coefficient performance for the refrigeration cycle and the heat pump, QL over WN and QH over WN. Couldn't find the one that we technically have posted in Moodle, so I grabbed this one from Stanford University. This is a thermodynamic table of Freon 22, which is the Freon we'll be using. Don't worry about the red box. But we use this table in our calculations, or this chart in our calculations. And we talk about the given an example of the evaporator pressure at 500 kilopascals and the condenser pressure at 1200 kilopascals. Going back to that previous table, we can read it off. We can read off on this side, going into this megapascals, so we go over to read the saturated vapors, evaporated saturated liquid line. We can find that our QL is going to be at 292 kilojoules per kilogram, and our WN will be about 80 kilojoules per kilogram. When we take that plug into our COP, QL over heat over work, we have 292 over 80, which gives a comes out to about 3.65 kilojoules, or 3.65, sorry, the units on this. So that would be our coefficient performance. So that's the experiment for next week to the air conditioner. Are there any questions?
Like, what exactly do we measure in the experiment, and like, how will you arrive at this conclusion?
As I said earlier, we're going to measure pressure and temperature at these four spots, and then we're going to take that as pressure at the condenser and the evaporator. It's my understanding the lab is a little confusing as to how exactly this is going to happen. We're going to take those and plug them in, and knowing the pressure and making sure the temperature is at saturated and liquid and vapor, we can then come up with a coefficient performance. Sorry, what?
That's good. We can do the work.
Okay. Is there